Good morning. Welcome to McQueenie Baptist Church. We are so happy to have you here today to worship with us on this beautiful Easter Sunday. We are so glad to have you. We're glad that we are able to perform today, do this program for you. Pray that your heart is sensitive and ready to hear what it is the Lord has to say in your life today. So we are here today celebrating Easter, the greatest event in all of human history. Because the scriptures tell us that Christ came, he was crucified, he was buried, but he did not remain in the grave. The scriptures tell us that he is risen.
He is risen indeed.
Amen. Let's worship together this morning.
People of the risen King. We are children of the living God. That's why we celebrate not only today, Resurrection Sunday, but every Lord's Day. We are united in him, and with one voice we sing. Because you have created all things, and by your will they exist and were created.
Thank you.
like you. There are no works like yours. We bow down before you, Lord, and will honor your name. For you are great and perform wonders. You alone are God.
See, on the hill of Calvary, my Savior bled for me. My Jesus set me free. Look at the wounds that give me life, grace flowing from his side, no greater sacrifice. Freedom he has won, even death is dead and done, his life is overcome. Speak, say the name above all names, over every broken place, he is risen from the grave. Throne of majesty, the Father's will complete, he reigns in victory. Sing hallelujah to the King, he is worthy to receive all the worship we can bring.
Please stop.
Our souls sing with the thought of him, what he has done, for sending his son to cleanse us from our sins. So when we come together, we must always remember to celebrate Jesus, his birth, his life, his journey to the cross, and finally, his empty tomb.
Man of sorrows, Lamb of God, by his own betrayed, the sin of man and wrath of God has been on Jesus slain.
Oh,
now we wait for that day when he will come again and take us to heaven. And on that day, every knee will bow in heaven and on earth.
Jesus came forth to be born of
God proved his love for us, and that while we were still sinners, Christ died for us. There is nothing that we can do to earn or deserve his love. And if we belong to him, there is nothing we can do that would make him turn his back on us. For we are saved by grace through faith, and it is not from ourselves. It is God's gift, not from works, so that no one can boast. God's grace is not just given to us once at salvation, but throughout our lives. He lavishly pours it out upon us day after day. The gift of God's grace and love is immeasurable. It is impossible to fully comprehend what is the length and width, height and depth of God's love. So come, accept his invitation to have all your sins, past, present, and future, forgiven.
Day of the week, very early in the morning, the women took their spices they had prepared and went to the tomb. They found the stone rolled away from the tomb, but when they entered, they did not find the body of the Lord Jesus. And while they were wondering about this, suddenly two men in clothes that gleamed like lightning stood beside them. In their fright, the women bowed down and their faces to the ground. But the men said to them, "Why do you look for the living among the dead? He is not here. He is risen." This day in history separates and divides all of time. Coming up to this event, the world sat lost in darkness, and people like us, broken, lost, directionless, without a purpose, without meaning, and truly without life. But God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish but have everlasting life. So Jesus in His grace and His mercy and His glory, chose to come to this earth and take on the robe of human flesh, to live a sinless, perfect life, to be crucified, placed into a borrowed tomb. But on the third day, the greatest miracle of all time took place, and Jesus came back to life and came out of that tomb, declaring to the world that our sins can now be forgiven, that we can now have new life in Him. And now He sits at the right hand of God the Father, declaring that those who come to Him by faith, those who trust in Him, can have their sins forgiven. They can live, not only presently, have real life, but we can also live eternally with Him in heaven. So today, this is an invitation. You've heard the gospel presented in the music that we've heard and the narration that we've experienced this morning. So now the question is, what will you do with that? Because that is really the question of Easter. What will you do with Jesus Christ? Some of you here this morning, you may be religious, maybe you've attended church, maybe you never have. But I'm here today to tell you that the most important decision you will ever make is to say yes to Jesus Christ. Receive Him as your Lord and Savior, and receive the new life and eternal life that He promises to you. I'm going to ask you to stand with me. We're going to take just a few moments. As I said, this is a real invitation, inviting you to respond to what it is that God may be saying to you this morning. And I believe that He is speaking to some of you. And I'll be here at the front of the auditorium. Maybe you just need to come and pray at the altar. Maybe you want to say yes to Jesus, and I would love to pray with you this morning. Whatever the decision you need to make right now, this is your time as we worship together.
I count on one thing, the same God that never fails. He will not fail me now. He won't fail me now in the waiting. The same God who's never late, His word.
Okay. Thank you so much. Thank you again for being here today to join us. I just wanted to mention, for those of you that may not be regular attenders here at McQueenie Baptist Church, today, you know, we have two different services here at McQueenie. We have what we call our McQueenie Classic Service. It's its own brand. I tell you, it's great. And so we have that in our 9:30 service, and then we have a contemporary worship service at 11. And today we have the pleasure of having both of our worship teams together, our choir and all the musicians. Wasn't the music great? The singing was amazing. And you know, and these are our own musicians doing the backup music here, and it's just so wonderful. We appreciate them so very much. Today, I want to make just a few quick announcements. First of all, I wanted to share with you that Registration is closed for our children's camp this summer, and we have every space is filled. I also wanted to mention that we had one generous member here that wants to remain anonymous that paid for all 10 kids to go to camp, and so what a wonderful blessing that is. Yeah. April 22nd is the Festival for Life. You know, here at McQueenie, we strongly support our South Texas Pregnancy Care Center for the work that they do in caring for moms and dads, but more importantly, caring for those beautiful unborn children that they would they do all that they can to see those children actually have life and come into this world. And so we want to support them. Saturday, April 22nd, 11 o'clock to 3 o'clock. I don't think I mentioned this in the first service. Our bluegrass band is going to be playing at the Festival for Life. And so you come out and support them. And there's all kinds of activities for children and games and food. And so come out and support the South Texas Pregnancy Care Center. And then on Sunday afternoon, April the 23rd at 5 o'clock in the afternoon, we are going to have the joy and the privilege of ordaining to the gospel ministry Connor Palmer, our student minister here at McQueenie Baptist Church, okay? So let's give a round of applause for that. So that's going to be great. And you get to come and be a part of that. There's an ordination service is a beautiful occasion. We invite you to come and support Connor and his family. And, of course, Jamie's, a big part of that as well, right? Yeah, yeah. We don't. Most people don't realize the load that that wives of pastors carry. So, anyway, looking forward to that. Vacation Bible School is coming up this summer. We got to get ahead of the game. In order to have the decorations that we want, we're going to have to actually make them this year. So all of you creative people, we're going to invite you to come. There's going to be a workshop on Saturday, April the 15th, 9 to 3. We're going to make our own decorations. And also, those of you that aren't so creative, that doesn't leave you out. You can help. You can hand people stuff. You know, I know you don't have a clue about how to make it decorative, but you can help, okay? So come and join the show. Then, do we know what happens 3 weeks from now? Okay, our annual McQueenie Baptist Church car show and fun fair we're going to have on that Saturday, which is the official date, is April the 29th, 9 o'clock to 2 o'clock. This is an outreach into our community. This is just a way that we reach out into our community. In fact, we call it our thank you to our community car show. And so it doesn't cost anybody anything to come and be a part of this. We're going to have jump houses and activities for children, fair for the kids. We're going to have the car show. Now, here's the thing. We have really gone all out on the car show this year. So what we need to do is get people to come and enjoy it. So you'll see most of it. Did you receive one of these when you came in this morning? Okay, some of you did, some of you didn't. If you did not receive these, pick up some of these, take them and hand them out to your friends, invite them to come to the car show on that Saturday. Okay, we appreciate all that our crew is doing. By the way, those of you that are helping with the car show, you're going to have a volunteer meeting on Sunday afternoon, April the 16th. April 16th at 5 o'clock in the afternoon to kind of go over plans, do the last-minute planning for the show. Okay, and finally, last but not least, we are having an Easter egg hunt right after the service. Yeah. I didn't, did I? You know what? Here's the thing. I thought I was doing really good today. And I just want to tell y'all this, and it's just, you know, okay, right at the top of my list is collect connection cards. So it's like it's in bright red, and you haven't done that. But I intentionally was saving that to the end. So all the announcements are done. What we're going to do now is give you 1 minute and a half, and we're way ahead. So 1 minute and a half we're going to give you to take your bulletin out. If you don't have a bulletin, if you'll hold your hand up, we'll bring you one. But we're going to ask everybody, not just our visitors, everybody that's here, to take a moment. We're going to give you a minute and a half to fill out the connection card. As soon as you fill it out, you can go ahead and pass it to the center aisle. We would appreciate this so much. This just gives us a clue of who all's here this morning, and also your prayer requests on the back. Put your prayer requests. We will pray for those this week. So let's do that starting right now. Minute and a half. We don't have... Okay. I was just informed that where we normally do our Easter egg hunt out in the field is really muddy. And so we're going to have our Easter egg hunt in the little courtyard to this side of the church, okay? And it's all ready. As soon as we dismiss, we can be able to go out and take your kids out for the Easter egg hunt, okay? So thank y'all so much for being here. We're going to have one more song. So as we exit today, let's go, choir. Father, we thank you this morning for the grace of God. Father, we thank you this morning for your grace and your goodness. We thank you for the glorious gospel that has been presented today in such a beautiful fashion through song. And God, we pray that you would cause it to sink deep into our minds and into our hearts. Lord, that we would fully grasp the significance of what Easter really, really does mean. Lord, we thank you for what you've done for us. We thank you for that beautiful love that you poured out for us at Calvary. And Lord, we ask you to go with us now today as we leave this place, that we would go with a great joy that comes from knowing Jesus Christ, our Savior. We pray this in Christ's name. Amen. God bless you as you go.